All right, it gives me great pleasure to introduce episode 113's top five Christmas songs this year with the wonderful George Gasson, the man who plays the drum week in, week out for Hastings, coming in to replace Safety Dave. I mean, there's a lot of things you could say there. I mean,
There's
could
no
the...
replacement for safety, Dave, is there?
No,
So
there isn't. As I can see, George already watching his words because he knows that Dave is desperate to ban him from the pilot field. Yeah, as George has already said that I look like Eddie Izzard. I obviously take that as a great compliment, and bless you, my child. First of all, George, though, how are you, and how's your preparations for Christmas?
Christmas preparations going very, very well. Shame not to have a Hastings game for 10 days, but what is there really to do? I'm gonna go get some food tomorrow, and that's all it, isn't it?
Okay, and so you'll be spending it with your loved ones, yeah?
Yeah, just with the other half is Christmas.
Okay.
Yeah, so looking forward to that. And then a nice game for me on Boxing Day, Folkestone away.
Yeah, bit of a bugger. Can't get to that one. I'm sure lots of Hastings fans will be suitably stuffed and heading to Folkestone. Okay, well, look, as you are the guest, George, please furnish me with your first tune.
Are we in any order, or are we going 5-1
We
here?
well, mine are in no order. So if you want to do 5-1, that's absolutely up to you, sir. So please tell me your first tune.
Let's do them in a random order. Let's start off with an underrated, underplayed tune, and that is Christmas Wrapping by the Waitresses.
Right. I'm not sure I've heard this one, you know.
Oh, you've heard it. You've heard it.
Oh, of course I have. Yes. Sorry. Yeah, good tune. So, any particular reason why you chose this one?
Underrated banger, super bass line. I decided not to bore your listener with actually musically analysing these tracks, just picking them on vibe. But superb song about doing what you want to do at Christmas. Don't worry about anyone else. Great message, great tune, party song.
Yeah. Exactly. Bah humbug. Yeah, so this was three girls, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. And who wouldn't like three girls around Christmas? Anyway, I keep disappearing. My camera's annoying me, but yes. Well, all of us that are a little bit more older would have heard this one, so good choice, George.
Thanks very much. Strong start.
Yeah. Right, okie dokie. We're going to move on to my first choice. Now, obviously, I did five beforehand, so this is my top five of about the zillion albums I've got of Christmas. So just bear with me, and I shall. Oh, you got to head off first with a bit of David Essex. No one. David Essex, who is in my eyes undefeated. Is it going to play? Oh, right. We all know everyone. Anyone that thinks of Christmas, think of David Essex. You think of the neckerchief. I mean, what else can I say? I mean, the great hare. There's always a roasting fire near him. Yeah, a good bit of ham. Who could knock a good bit of ham over Christmas, eh?
This is what it's all about, Chris. This is what it's all about, tunes like this.
I'm there, mate. I'm there. I usually like the ones where he's got the he'll posture, like go on a rock, put one leg up on a rock, just like, you know, just yeah, it's good stuff.
I've heard a lot of those covers of Christmas songs this Christmas, where they're played on an 80s keyboard.
All right.
Just waiting for the DJ button to be pressed. And they're all aiming, they're all trying, they're reaching for this, but they're not getting there.
You're not, are you? Well, it was only a winter's tale. Can I drink to that? Just another winter's day. As you know, I've got massive credibility, I have. Right. That's my choice. Let's turn that one down. Goodbye, David. Right, Georgie Porgy, what is your next tune?
Well, a bit like a top band where you're waiting for their biggest hit. I'm going to get this one out of the way so we're not waiting for it. And I'm going to put Gaudete in the mix.
Right. Any particular reason for this tune?
Just Technical musical brilliance, beautiful, makes you think of a dark Christmas Eve night. Choral singing, singing in your own accent as well, really important. Great harmonies, just lovely, warm. You always want to put this on when you're having some nibbles with the family at Christmas time.
Oh yeah, definitely nice background music, this one. You don't expect, like, say, Howie coming in on the end of this to continue it.
No, no, you.
No.
Go. Go.
So that might be one more person that listens to this podcast. It could possibly be that Howie listens this week.
Obviously, he's going to listen. Yeah, he's been name checked now, so he's going to tune.
Yes. Anyway. We love I'm all our fan base. Sorry, go on, George.
I'm surprised Ben Bennett hasn't changed the lyrics and done a Hastings song in Latin about all 15 players. Disappointed, to be honest. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, he's letting us down, isn't he?
Yeah, he is, yeah. Too busy focusing on the Arsenal, but he'll get there.
Well, he's only done one good song, in my opinion, and we know what that one is, don't we? So
follow Hastings away.
Well, he's in a pub still, that one. I like that one.
That is good. Nice.
Yeah, that was good. That was good.
All the good songs for the players that leave straight away.
I know he's got a good skill at that. Actually, you were the best. You didn't you do one? Who was it that?
Karen Misiaka didn't even play a game. Yeah.
I mean, that's incredible, isn't it?
Yeah. I think he's at Chatham now.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And was you not the creator of the wonderful and one of the best players we've ever had, Tyler Christian Law's tune? Weren't you as well? That wonderful ditty.
So what happened there? Was that we wrote the song, it kicked off in the clubhouse, people singing it, and then he asked for another one, and then the form of the team and him sort of went downhill after that. So there you go. Tyler's feedback, it hit the whole team, that's what it was. it wasn't very captain-y, just to say that, really. So wanting another tune wasn't, you know, there you go. Wouldn't catch Adam Lovett asking for a third song, would you?
Anyway. Right, let's move on to my choice. So the next one will be... Oh, I'll tell you what, I think it's got to be a bit of time for a bit of Big Frank.
That's good. That's nice. Yeah. There's no Frank on my list, so that's nice that you...
Oh, yeah, well, that's good. That's good to hear.
That's nice. Yeah.
Now, this is just something I feel like I'm without a hat. Bear with me 1 second. I need another hat. What about this one, George? What do we think?
It's good. I don't know why you're so worried about your hairline. For your age, it looks very good.
Would you say, mate?
I don't know why you're so worried about your hairline. For your age, it looks very good.
No, the hair's gone. I'm not as bad as Ben Bennett, let's be fair, in terms of hair. So I officially don't look like a Christmas pudding. I look a bit like a penis, to be honest.
You do look a bit like a penis.
Phallic symbol. Let's
get that off. It was the one, last one looked like balls over your face.
Anyway, Big Frank, love Big Frank, got many albums of Big Frank, and what a voice, a great Christmas song.
Classic, absolute classic, Chris.
Beauty.
Love this one.
Okay, right. Come Let Us Adore Him, is this a song about Aggie?
It could well be, couldn't it?
It could be, couldn't it? Chris, Agatha.
Yeah,
could be.
It's
not like a Gene song, but we won't go there. Okay. worry about that one. Anyway, right then, a wonderful tune. Right, let's move on now to the lovely George's third choice.
Well, I'm going to go for what I think would be my favourite. When I put this in the middle, this is "Ring Out Solstice Bells," Jethro Tull.
Jethro Tull, eh?
Yeah.
Is that loud enough?
Perfect.
Yeah, it's a good tune, this one. Just one of those classics. It seems like where you get like the Slade. This is your album, your Christmas throughout.
The best of, that's in there.
better. I can't have my turkey on my head anymore. I say, yeah, hairline looking, not looking too good there. What can we do?
No, again, I think this is another one that's a bit underrated, a bit underplayed.
Mm. Oh, Christ, this was it. Mariah Carey.
Yeah, Fairy Tale of New York.
What else they play now? Because I don't listen to radio.
Last Christmas.
There's always a place for Last Christmas. But...
yeah, no, none of those songs are bad, but this one should be played a bit more. Mm.
Something about Under the Mistletoe.
Yeah. Great harmonies.
What? I wonder who has kissed under the mistletoe at the pilot bar. Are we willing to start any rumours or?
Well, what goes on in the pilot bar has got to stay in the pilot bar, isn't it, Chris? You've got to turn up. Got to turn up to see it.
Well, we remember the mannequin. Anyway. There we go. Anyway, we're done for that then. Right, so. Very good choice there, George.
Oh, yeah, that's where the mannequin arm went. Yeah, it's gone. It is no more.
Comedy timing. Right, so my third choice. I have a lot of Christmas albums, I've said quite a few times. But one of my favourite ones that I used to play to my older kids was the Ren and Stimpy Christmas album. For anyone that doesn't know, Ren and Stimpy was a 90s cartoon, kind of adult-ish cartoon. And this tune is called The 12 Days of Yaxmas. So I'm just going to stick that on now, Stimpy.
One year I do want to do top five worst ones with you. That'd be quite nice.
Well, I had the Andre Rhea album on earlier. Andre Rhea's Christmas. And like one or two of them are actually not bad.
You know, he's like, all right. Charlotte don't like him because she said he looks creepy.
Mailman, got your mail here.
Hey, Ren, you got a package. And look at the size of it.
Hang on.
Wow.
This is very you, Chris.
Ollie Black. Ollie Black.
It's Ignoramia. And it's written in Ignoramish. Sven.
Right, this is a great tune. Open it. Is that too loud?
Oh, boy.
It's fine.
Stimpy, you're never going to believe what he sent.
Tell me.
On the first day of Yaxmas, cousin Sven, he sent to me a nose goblin stuck to a chair.
Maybe you had to see
on the second day of Yaxmas, cousin Sven, he sent to me two jars of spit and a nose goblin stuck to a chair. On the third day of Yaxmas, cousin Sven, he sent to me three used bandages, two jars of spit, and they nose goblin start to
Ben Bennett couldn't do better than this.
No.
Of Yaxmas cousin Sven, he sent to me four stay-put socks, three used bandages, two jars of and they nose goblin start to a chair.
We'll get to five, alright?
On the fifth day of Yaxmas cousin Sven, he sent to me five golden hairballs. Four stay-put socks, three used bandages, two jars of spit, and a nose goblin start to a chair. On the sixth day of Yaxmas, cousin Sven, he sent to me six yaks are shaven, five.
Hey, let's not talk about shaven.
Well, that is a genuinely good reworking of the 12 Days of Christmas. I'll give you that. Have you heard the worst one?
No. Who is it by?
Destiny's Child. 8 Days of Christmas.
Hey?
Yeah, if you listen to that, it will make you cry and cancel Christmas. It's honestly, I never thought a Christmas song could be this bad, but it is.
Seriously? Well, yeah. Maybe next year, George, we'll look at that, I think.
Yeah, worst ones, because there is some dross. There's some really bad stuff.
Well, I'm sure, talking of dross, I think Bross did a Christmas song as well as, well, I know, what they called E17 did one. Which I still think is terrible, but
it's not a Christmas song. That is not a Christmas song. It's about his brother's suicide. It's not a good Christmas song.
But then why are they, you know, all dressed in white and they're all... Anyway, let's not get...
To make the money.
To make the money, mate. Your choice, George.
Right, we'll go for a bit of Bing.
Bit of Bing. Something
you like. And the classic, that is White Christmas.
Oh, I think on my last one, I did the Bing with David Bowie. I'm not sure. I can't remember what I did.
Yeah, I think you did actually.
That's
yeah.
probably the one I went for.
Yeah.
But Oh, he's.
Didn't no, didn't Dave
Or did
didn't
Dave
Dave?
do that? I can't remember.
I think Dave went for that, you know.
I was just in awe of Safety Dave keeping me safe.
Yeah. Well, he kept you safe until he chose the Queen one.
First Christmas.
Christmas.
So I mean, you sit, you're listening to this. This is absolute must play over Christmas period.
Yeah, this is iconic. This is play it when you're having a wine with your nan, but also put it on in the clown and everyone will sing along. Perfect.
Oh, I was in the Clown Friday.
Yeah. All right, we was in there Saturday. Still
Oh, you're gonna
smells.
say, did the guy with the wig on his head, was he in?
That could be anyone in the clown. But it was still packed. It smells a bit better for anyone that's been in the last few weeks. The
Oh.
clown now smells a bit better. They've taken the sprouts out of the microwave, and but obviously it's still the best pub in the town. So
Absolutely indeed. Talking of pubs, if anyone's about, I may be having a few pints on Christmas Eve in the Dolphin. I try and do it every year. So that's the 24th Christmas Eve for people that don't know. Sometimes people need to be told, but that's not just because I'm sad and lonely. I will be with other people, but just in case, it's nice to bump into people in the old town. Always nice.
it's
Right.
good to send out a warning to the dolphin as well that you're going to be there,
Hake.
and they'll have less custom on that day.
That's a hate crime. And I know, obviously, you think I look like Eddie Izzard, but anyway, enough of that. Okay, right. A wonderful song that we've ruined by talking over. Let's go to my choice. This is one I was thinking. I've known this tune many, many years. When my kids were first knocking around, it was part of it was absolute essential that had to come on. It's Marshall Brothers and Mr. Santa's Boogie. It's a lovely tune as well. Yep, love this tune. I've got nothing funky to say about this song. What are you doing Christmas? So Boxing Day, obviously Hastings.
Yep.
Then after that, are you going to go see family or a family coming to you?
We've seen family, really. We're going to do another big trip in February. We're just enjoying being at home over Christmas. When we're not at home, we're at a Hastings game. So,
That you are. You're always at Aces games. It's got to be St. Romeo.
we've got five aways in a row, haven't we, coming up?
Oh, no. That is a killer. I don't know how many I'm going to be able to make of those, but. Anyway. Right. Well. Anyway, enough of that one. I love that tune. Right then. So, it is now your fifth choice. What is it going to be, sir?
Well, I know I've said a few are overplayed, and this one is a bit, but it's overplayed for a reason. Step into Christmas, Elton. This one for me would be a good song, even if it wasn't about Christmas and the topic was changed. It's still a really good Elton John song.
Oh yeah.
First on the jukebox, this one, every time.
Oh yeah, I mean it's, no one could hate this tune. I mean it's just come on. Yeah, it's funny this one because like he used to get a free pass. My old man used to get he would say this is fine. But if he ever heard Simply Having a Wonderful Christmas Time by Paul McCartney, he would
Yes.
try and smash things up. Whereas I'm not, I can tolerate both.
This is the better track, though. It was between this for my last one and Baby Please Come Home.
Oh, okay. Okay.
But Baby Please Come Home was co-written and produced by Phil Spector, so that one lost out.
Oh, that's slightly woke of you, isn't it? Is that?
He did a bit of murdering, to be fair, and
Hasn't everyone?
he idolised Wagner, who I hate. No. Yeah, so
Well, that's definitely not good, is it?
no. It was more the Wagner thing than the murdering, to be honest. The murdering is actually reasonable, but idolising that German bastard is not.
Let's not talk about the war. Right.
No offence, Henning, if you're listening.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, Henning's done, actually, if he's listening to this, Henning done a great Christmas message, just so, and that will be out with this episode when it comes out, so. Anyway, great tune. Great tune. So, I will play my last track. It is The Temptations.
Mm-hmm.
Better be the right version. Right, nice little drummer boy by The Temptations. Yeah, this is the right version. A great tune anyway. Yes, it is cheating because I said I'm sure the David Bowie tune was the last time. But I like
it's
this
not cheating.
As well.
It's, I mean, covers of Christmas songs are important if they're good.
Like the deepest voice in the world is in the background there, whoever that bloke is. He could be up there with Ollie Black in terms of. Well, we're not going to go there. But the. Anyway.
No, great. Nice.
Thank you. Well, first of all, thank you for this, George. I hope we could continue this if and when anyone listens to this podcast and I carry on. Do it next Christmas.
Yeah, let's do the five worst ones next Christmas. Let's do it. Let's dig them out.
Could be. I think because it will require some homework.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, well, it gives me great pleasure to send out all our love. Merry Christmas to all Hastings fans that are listening, or anyone that's listening. Even Nori's mum, she might still be listening out there in the Bermuda Triangle. Thank you, George. I must say also thanks for your great support of this club over the seasons as well. So it should never be forgotten, consistently there, so, and always get behind the team. But George,
been a pleasure, Chris.
Take care, mate, and have a wonderful Christmas.
When is this one out?
Roundtable's Wednesday recording, and Saturday the podcast is out.
Super. I'll make sure I tune in, double your listenership for this week, and
Billy Wood numbers, that'll be about 2,000 people.
Yes,
yeah, there you go.
And all of them children. Yeah.
And on that note, love to Billy, and love to everyone.
Yeah, have a great Merry Christmas, everyone. Merry Christmas, Chris.
Yeah, cheers, mate. Take care.
Take care.